a lot of the soldiers, they didn't like him. They didn't like him at all. They felt he was too strict. He was too much of a martinet, that he couldn't relax, loosen up. And that was
not
one of the
parties.
Pardon?
Not even at a party?
Not, well, here's the party one that comes along. Shortly after this, just before the Battle of Stones River, Maddie Reddy's wedding took place. Now, this is the woman who marries John Hunt Morgan. And the story goes that about a year before the wedding took place, she didn't even know Morgan, but she heard her father had been a congressman and everything, and the family was pretty well off, one of the pillars of society in Murfreesboro. And she heard two Union officers discussing John Hunt Morgan in a very depreciating way. And she walked up to them and proceeded to berate them regarding Morgan and saying that someday, you know, she might just find herself as being the bride of John Hunt Morgan. She didn't know him at all, but her brother did. And her brother, when he heard the story, invited Morgan to their home for dinner. He met Maddie. He was a widower at this point. She had never been married. She was only like 17, 18 years old. And he pretty much swept her off her feet. And they were married in her parents' home by Leonidas Polk, Bishop Polk.
Really?
Who was a Confederate general. Actually conducted the wedding ceremony. Now, Bragg was in attendance, as was his entire staff. And this was not too long after he had had a meeting with Jefferson Davis, in which Davis had told him, Brax, loosen up, baby. You know, have some fun. You know, to take things a little easier. So he was trying to enjoy himself at the wedding. And as he was at the wedding, he's walking around with Maddie, talking to different people, and they hear all this laughter coming from one of the rooms in the house. So they started towards the room to see what was going on. And just as they reached the door, Morgan comes walking out the door, sees Bragg as his new bride, sees where they're headed, and quickly intervenes, takes his wife, and walks away. She did not understand why until later. When Bragg walked through that door, there was the regimental surgeon, Dr. Yandell, who was doing impersonations of various officers. And as Bragg walked through the doorway, and no one saw him until it was too late, Yandell was impersonating Braxton Bragg.
Oh, gosh, how did that go?
Well, it went on for about a minute or so before someone realized Bragg was standing there just staring, and all of a sudden,
the room
got real quiet, and Yandell looked around and realized himself, oh, my God, the old man is standing there watching me. And he starts sputtering in an apology, and Bragg held up his hand and said, that's perfectly fine, doctor. Continue. And then said, continue again a second time, almost as if a command. Naturally, that Yandell did not. By that point, he was pretty embarrassed. So, but that's the way that army was. You would never dream of anyone doing an impersonation of Robert E. Lee.